some Simply Potatoes. Hey everyone, and welcome to my channel. I'm Nikki, and today's video is going to be a little bit of a meal prepping video. So I decided that I guess I'm feeling nice and I want to prep some food for Adam for the week. He has a long weekend of work, and actually a long week in general. He has to pick up some extra shifts because just to fill in some people on vacation and stuff. So I want to help him out and make him some meals for the week to pack for work. And I always get questions asking for some meal prep ideas. So today I'm going to be making three things that he can bring with him for work, and they're going to be lower point options, a little bit higher in protein, and just some of his favorite things to have. So if you enjoy this video or find it helpful, please go ahead and give it a like and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. And let's get started. So with the pasta salad that I'm making, I'll probably have enough for me to have a serving or two, but the other two things I'm making are just going to be for him because I personally am not a huge fan of overnight oats, but he loves them. So I'm going to be making him three servings of overnight oats. Then I'm going to be making a pasta salad because that's something that's really quick and easy to just grab the container and bring with, and he can just have it cold. He also eats his oats cold. I like to heat them up, but you can do either with these. But with the pasta salad, it's nice because it's a cold option, but it's going to be a good higher protein option as well. So I'm excited for that. I'm going to be making a BLT style pasta salad. I'm going to be making banana overnight oats, and then I think I'll do two banana and one berry because I've got some strawberries and blueberries here. And then the last thing that I'm making is something that he has just been loving. So I recently made him breakfast burritos that I prepped and just kept in the freezer, and they were his favorite thing ever. He thanked me every time he had one. He just loved them so much. So I'm going to make him some more breakfast burritos. I pretty much just make my normal like hash brown scramble, and then that's the filling for the burritos. Okay, so for the breakfast burritos, it's easier if I use the larger tortillas. So that's what I'm using today. We do prefer the La Banderitas, but I couldn't find them at the store and we only had one left. So I'm going to use one of these, 2 points on Weight Watchers. And then same with the Extreme Wellness, also 2 points. And then for the rest of them, I'm just going to be using these. So next time I'll probably just do the La Banderita, but for now the Extreme Wellness works. It's still a good lower point option and it's filling. It's got 18 grams of fiber in one of them, and same with the La Banderita. But anyway, I'm just going to make that with some scrambled eggs, some Simply shredded hash browns, and then some turkey sausages. So last time I did bacon, this time I want to do turkey sausage. So I'm just going to heat some of these up and chop them up and mix them into the scramble. And then I don't have any veggie mix made right now, but the pepper and onion mix from Trader Joe's works really well. So I'm just going to use that. I'll just add it to the skillet as I'm cooking everything. I've got some water boiling for the pasta right now, but while that's boiling, I'm going to go ahead and make the overnight oats first so I can just pop those in the fridge. And then I'll get the stuff prepped for the pasta salad. The pasta has to cool anyway, so even if I chop all the stuff up, I'm just going to let it sit for a minute. And then right now, I'm going to start a pan with some nonstick olive oil spray and some hash browns. So I'm going to get those cooking first because I like to let the hash browns cook a little bit longer. And then I'll add in the peppers, the sausage, the eggs, and then I might do some cheese on them as well, but just a little bit. So I'm going to go ahead and get started.
Before I started with the oats, I wanted to get the hash browns started in a pan, so I just sprayed them with some nonstick olive oil spray, and I also started boiling the water for the pasta. And I love using mason jars for the overnight oats. It's just so quick and easy for me to throw them together. They're easy for Adam to take to work, and they stay sealed and everything in the fridge. So anyway, I'm starting with a banana for each of the banana flavored ones I'm doing, and then I'm gonna do berries in the other, which I'm just using some fresh blueberries and strawberries in. With a fork, I just mash up the bananas. They weren't very ripe. I had just gotten them, so it did take a little bit of extra mashing to get them nice and soft, but once I did, they were perfect. Then while I was doing that, the pasta finished up cooking. My timer went off, so I went ahead and just strained it in the sink. And then I just used some nonstick olive oil spray on the pasta once it's been strained to help it from sticking together. Then I got back to working on the oats and just mashed up the strawberries and blueberries. I am using some Fairlife fat-free skim milk for these oats today, so I just add a half cup to each jar. And with the overnight oats, I just find it easier to mix all the like liquid ingredients before adding the oats in, so that's why I'm just adding them in this order. I add the milk, and then I got distracted with the hash browns. I've just been mixing those every once in a while, but I wanted to add the veggies into them. And usually I would use some prepped veggie mix, but I didn't have any made at the moment, so I just used these frozen peppers and onions from Trader Joe's. They're roasted and have really good flavor, and they're super convenient to just have on hand at all times. So I added a good amount of those into the hash browns. And the veggies I just put in frozen, but they end up cooking up with the potatoes. So while those are cooking, I'm adding some peanut butter to the oats, which I just use my food scale to reverse weigh the serving. And I just like to use this creamy peanut butter from Trader Joe's. I weighed out a 2-point serving, which was 14 grams. I keep the hash browns cooking for like 10 to 15 minutes usually before I add the rest of the ingredients. So I'm just quickly finishing up the oats with some chocolate donut flavor god seasoning and then some cinnamon. Once I add those in, I give it another good mix, and then I add a half cup of old fashioned oats to each mason jar. And every time I do this, I make such a mess. So I finally learned to just put it onto a paper towel and then kind of funnel it into the jar, and that makes it much easier. So I'm just adding a half cup of oats to each one. And that's everything that goes in the overnight oats. So I just seal them tightly after that and shake them up, and then they get stored in the refrigerator overnight. And then obviously he's not gonna take all three tomorrow. So they last in the fridge for usually like 3 to 5 days. So then going back to the hash brown filling for the wraps, I removed it from the heat for a minute just because it was cooking too much, but I was dicing up these turkey sausages. Originally I was going to heat them up in the microwave for a minute, but they had thawed long enough sitting out that I could just dice them up and add them to the pan to heat them as I cooked it. And I knew I was going to be getting 4 or 5 wraps, so I wanted to do at least 1 egg to 2 eggs per wrap. I decided to just do 8 eggs in the scramble, and once they were all cracked, I just mixed them all together. Then while the eggs were cooking, I got a little sidetracked and made the sauce for the pasta salad, which was just 2 tablespoons of light mayo and 2 tablespoons of Bolthouse Farms Fire Chili Ranch. And I just used my food scale to weigh out both of those portions. Then I continually mix up the eggs to cook them with the hash brown scramble until they're fully done. And then I almost forgot to add it, but I did add some reduced fat cheese to the scramble and then finished it up. Going back to the dressing for the pasta salad, I added some salt and pepper, and then I just whisked together the dressing and the mayo. I added it to the protein pasta that was cooked, and this was a full box, 14 and a half ounces of the Barilla Protein Plus Penne. So I just mixed that in with the noodles and then put it aside to chop everything up. So I'm starting with dicing up the green onion to add in. Then I had 5 slices of center cut bacon left, so I chopped that up as well. I had just cooked it earlier in the week, so it didn't need to be cooked or anything. I wanted to add some more protein to this to make it more filling, and I realized I had some chicken breast cooked in the fridge. So I had it from my local meal prep service, which is Duck a Diet. It's just plain grilled chicken breast, and it was perfect to dice up and add to the salad because, again, it was just pre-cooked chicken. Then I wanted to add some grape tomatoes. Half of these are from our garden and half are from the store. I didn't have enough, so I just used what I had, and then I still had some in the fridge from before. So I diced those up and added them and then mixed everything together. And then I almost forgot, I added some diced romaine as well. So I just chopped that up and added about 2 cups of it. While I was making the pasta salad, the hash brown mix was able to cool down just a little bit. It doesn't have to cool perfectly, but it makes it just a little bit easier to make the wraps. So I divided it evenly between 5 of the tortillas. Once I had the filling divided, I just wrapped each one up and then wrapped it in some aluminum foil and put it in a gallon bag in the freezer.
Okay, so that wraps up everything that I'm meal prepping for Adam to take to work. He's all set now for his busy week that he has ahead. So I've got the pasta salad, which made 5 servings. Each serving comes out to 8 points total on Weight Watchers. Then I made 5 breakfast burritos. And what I do is I just wrap them in foil. It's easy for him to just unwrap. And he usually just pops them in the microwave. You could also heat them in the air fryer. Sometimes he saves them for when he's home if I make a lot of them. Or if he just brings them to work, he usually just puts them in the microwave. And then I've got his 3 containers of overnight oats. So you can see they mix together really well, and I'll just pop these in the fridge. And then, like I said, he eats them just cold, but you can also heat them up in the microwave, which is what I prefer to do. So the pasta is 8 points for 1 container. The breakfast burritos are 2 points for the tortilla. And then I just went ahead and tracked 3 points for the hash browns, sausage, and cheese, making each burrito 5 points total on Weight Watchers. And then the overnight oats come out to 6 points total. It's 3 points for the oats, 1 for the serving of milk that I used, and 2 for the peanut butter that I used. So 6 points for those. And that wraps up my video for today. I hope you guys enjoyed this and found it helpful. I'll have the recipes typed out in the description below. And if you enjoyed this video, please go ahead and give it a like and subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. It really helps me out. So if you could go ahead and like and subscribe, thank you so much. But I will see you guys next time. Thank you guys so much for watching.